Hey guys, I'm back. I got a Crimson Vow opening to do for you guys. Been opening up some draft packs and ended up going to a sealed event where I was able to ask people if they didn't want these cards, if I could have them. And I now have, this was probably the quickest way I've been able to acquire it. I don't know if they're more common, but I did get all nine. So that's what they look like. I got a new camera set up here, or not really a new camera, but more about a new location. It is completely sunny outside, so I could not have asked for better indoor lighting at this place. And I'm dressed in all black today. This set is about a wedding, but really it's my own funeral because I have not had any luck opening anything sealed so far of this set. We're gonna keep that collector booster box sealed, and I've already cut the slit to just kind of speed up purposes here. The set does come with a box topper, unlike Midnight Hunt, which I was very happy with my Midnight Hunt pulls, but for me, if you're coming into this set or this block Innistrad or whatever, you want it because, like, hey, I want to join up on these things. Zombies, vampires, spirits, werewolves, humans. So here's the box topper. Look at that. That's like the arena loading screen. Oh my goodness, it's glued on so hard. I will mess with that later. I don't want to bend it. We're gonna do all 30 packs today. I ended up buying two boxes of this. I'm gonna keep the other sealed because, to be honest, there's really not a lot in this I need. And I really just wanna focus on maybe picking up some singles. Collector boxes are in the gutter. I mean, I bought that from my, I got that from my LGS, and the guy selling the store, he's found a buyer. He basically is gonna retire. I don't blame him. I'm hoping when the new guy comes over, he gets all the distributor deals, because really good value going to that place. I'm gonna miss the guy. I mean, he's not a Magic player, he's more of a sports card guy. So, you know, Magic wasn't his forte, but see if you guys can get this on here. Okay. I remember, I'm just kind of grouping, I group the cards by color here. You know what? You want to kind of see, there we go. Ridge Wool. Okay, so this is definitely a red pack. Magma Pillar, Frenzy's Devils, Child of the Pack. I'm gonna put the gold cards over here. I guess, like, I'm gonna miss them, but at the same time, it's like, maybe the new guy will hold more events. I'm gonna group all the vampire cards off in a corner here. It's not really, or maybe over here. Winged Portent, and our foil, and Vampire Wedding Planner. Okay, so mini game cards over here, white cards. I'm gonna put, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna kind of go. Remember, we gotta put a spot for the lifts too. So these packs are really thin, and they're coming apart really easily. Look at this. I like playing this card. This is Poor Man's Thoughtseize. Who is the artist for this? I got my Rovina Kai. That's cool. And I actually signed it. I hate getting the Planeswalker stamp. Anyways, so the guy's leaving, and I messed all that up. Oh, another braid. Another red pack here. Guy's leaving. Cool, I got the card. The Poor Man's Thoughtseize. So we're hopefully, hope the deals happen, or keep coming, because I need a place in person where I can, all right, we're off to a good start. This is the most expensive, slow land, black, green, and don't really need those anymore. We got our foil gold card. Okay, so, no mythics, but I will take slow lands over jank rares that will have no meaning after this step rotates. Remember, I'm trying to pull theme stuff. Hey, there's a foily. Finally got some. Okay, so hopefully this is a blue spirit blue pack, blue white pack. Fierce Retribution. I did so bad. All right, another wash away. That's my second. Did so bad at the sealed tournament. Went 0-3. I had so bad. So I played white green. I had no rares that I could play with. Wedding announcement. Junk. Huh. Okay, Wolf Token. That's my first token. And a foil common Fang Frame or something, whatever they want to call it. Again, back to my common here. I'm not really a big fan of this because if you don't like one of these themes, this set's not for you. And there's not enough staying power for this stuff. I mean, there's some good hits. Is that a foil? No. But there's nothing in here that, like, I feel you just can't go buy a single. The Planeswalkers, well, they're decent. They're not, you know, game-breaking. I don't know. I mean, like, as a block, it's fine. Very creature heavy. This is a bad pack, by the way. Okay, Change of Fortune by Sam Gay. I don't think there's any relation to Rebecca. But I do like, they almost have similar art. It's very weird. I don't know if they're trying to hide the fact that he's related and just aren't saying it. But really cool. Let's see what we got here. Some rare spirit card flips. I played against it on Arena. Let's see. Pyre Spawn. Reckless Impulse. This is, I think, going to be Geistlight Snare. Cost one less if you have a spirit. One less if you have an enchantment counter. And it becomes a mana leak. Possibly for one blue. Witness the Future. Weary Prisoner, Vampire Art, and Mirage. Oh, okay, so see this little symbol right here? This is from the Commander, or an exclusive Commander card here. I'm not even going to read it. We'll put this off to the side, because that's, our first Mythic, Hallowed Haunting, not worth anything. But really cool if you can get going. Does it transfer? No, it's like building on spirits and enchantments. And oh, so I guess we got two of those now. Okay, let me do a little upkeep here, kind of keep these piles in check. So that was our first Mythic. That was a dub. We haven't pulled any list cards. Typically a set box will have 7. You get 1 for 4 packs. Remember, there's 30 packs in a set box. Speaking of Hallowed Haunting, I got the art there. I don't even know, to be honest, man. I'm calling you guys men. I don't even know what I want out of this set. I'm just opening it because it's the latest Magic. I'm not hype on it. I like Werewolves more because Werewolves didn't get a lot of coverage before, you know, like they didn't have a lot of Commander. Hey, this is really good here. This is probably the best spirit in the deck. At the beginning of combat, tap something down or tap target creature. Really cool. You can choose up to one. Okay, we got Foil Braid. And we got a Blood Pet as our list card here. That's actually just going to go in. Man, this is not good. I guess we got to get the common one out of the way. In the original form, it's like a 30, 40 cent common, which is kind of, you know, hey, that's a lot but for an old common, but nothing. Wow, like I literally have been getting no variants. Or it's like, hey, the art card is going to be coming up in the pack. Or it's a green pack. I'll take a Cemetery Prowler, please. I need a wolf. I don't know. This might see some play. Lantern of the Lost. I think this is the opposite of the Soul Guide Lantern from Theros. So that might have some potential. That's actually our first mono, like, colorless artifact. Got some Fang Frame number 2. All right, blue green slow land. Ooh, and Torrens foil showcase art. Centering's a little off, but hey, I'll take it. I think this has a lot of potential for Commander. You know, 3 mana, 2/2 training, and then anytime I cast a creature, I get a 1/1 token with training. Oh, and then I'm already on to a Time Spiraled Ib Halfheart, Goblin Tactician. I could see it being hey, cool, I'll take it. We'll just put you with the regular rares. Okay, so we're at 2 slow lands, 1 mythic. I've already pulled the rare goblin on the list. I don't think I'm going to get any more list hits. I don't even know what's in the list. I don't even pay attention to it. I just, like, again, this is more for collecting and opening, not for drafting. I gotta realize that. I feel like these don't hold value, so I open them. I mean, not only not, okay, look at this. Katilda. Okay, Spirit. Oh, okay. Second, Mythic here. Jacob Hawken Inspector. I think he'd be great for control, because when you flip this thing at the beginning of your upkeep, exile top card of your library face down, and you can play a land or cast a spell among the cards exiled without paying its cost. So it becomes almost like a baby omniscience. So if you can somehow transform that guy, cool. Zombie. I've heard the slug tokens are like really hard to get in this set. So we're at two lists out of, we're still on wave one here, or row one. Again, if they're going to provide a special type of art for the lands in each set, cool. But then nothing becomes special. But I like how, you know, if that's the case, if you like something, you can get it really easily. Just like how if you needed a snow basic, you could have got that with Kaldheim. And I needed a lot of snow basics. I like playing snow. Oh, yes. Okay, so, oops. Sorry. Oh, my gosh. I'm getting excited. Okay. So I'm getting really good blue cards here. I got that Spirit. I got Hullbreaker Horror. This is kind of like Tide Spout Tyrant. Basically, flash can't be countered. When you cast a spell, choose up to one. Return a spell that you don't control to owner's hand, or return target non-land permanent to its owner's hand. So you can actually theoretically keep bouncing this if it gets targeted, because you can cast something and then bounce it back. Really good. Again, I'm getting some solid pulls. Okay, there's a little mini game number two. Okay, really good blue stuff. So Jacob, Horror, and Flying Spirit guy. I don't play a lot of spirits. I'd like Soren just for the flavor of it all. Okay, Foily Island, Scorpion. I'm actually going to run this if I was playing my... I actually like this, okay? I know it's no Giant Growth, but this is the power creep. You lose plus, you know, Giant Growth is, you know, +3/+3, but this Trample helps a lot. Same cost. There's the Mana Rock for the set. Got some Markov Waltzer, Markov Purifier. Okay, some Spirits. Innocent Traveler, Fang Frame, and a lot of this. See, like, I know these are going to be real common. Inspired Idea, I think this has potential in Modern, but I don't want to lose my hand. I don't really play a lot of control or anything like that. Has potential, though. And we got our third list card, Moonhold. I have no idea. This is Shadowmoor. Target player can't play land cards this turn if red was cast. And if white was cast, they can't play creature spells this turn. Okay. Kind of a cool lockdown, you know, hey, I'm going to beat you down. That was the end of row one. And we got three list cards, one common, one rare, one uncommon. All from an era where I actually played. So I wish I would have played during the Shadowmoor block. But, gosh, I am horrible with the grouping. I just kind of put them in piles. If I see anything of interest for me, I will pull it out and talk about it. Okay, we got Timothar, Baron of Bats. This is a mythic. This is coming from the Commander set. Looks like you make a lot of bats. And cool. Hamlet Vanguard. I don't know if that's good. I mean, 3 mana for a 1/1. It can enter with 2+1/+1 counters on it for each non-token human. So that can get really big in Commander. I just don't see that. I don't see that being a... that's a big spirit, 4/4. I don't see that being a... I mean, for 3 mana, you can play Lovestruck Beast. You can play that 5/4 elf can't be blocked by 2 or less. You can... I mean, I don't know. You 3/3 if you just play that wolf from the new... Dungeons and Dragons set. Speaking of wolves, this looks like a wolf pack. Though they threw me a curveball here. Zombie horse. That is so weird. It's so weird. I wish they would just call it like a zombie centaur or something. Catapult fodder. Be kind of cool if I could play black for my wall commander deck. If this thing transforms, you sack a creature, deals damage, or loses life equal to a toughness of that creature that you sacked. That's an eyeball. That's gross. Torin, the regular version. Oh, are you kidding? Ugh. Whatever. I'm not getting good list, especially with that rare. But man, four list cards, one. I mean, you gotta go farther back. I think list cards should not be, something cannot be in standard. That's the rule for list. But again, oh, shoot, I dropped a bunch. Sorry, party foul. I don't think I got to the rare yet. This was actually three white cards. White's actually my least so far. Black. So I'm doing a little cleanup phase here. Okay, back to the pack. This is back to the commons. Commons. Fang Frame. Ooh, that's a cool Fang Frame looking thing. And Howling Moon. I got that. That's how I lost. That was the only rare that I could play with in my white-green deck. So far, I don't think I pulled anything. This is not worth the price, but again, you know, we're having fun. It's a new Magic set. Not good at opening these packs. There's that Spirit card. See, the problem with this is, even if you do pull something good, you can literally buy these cards for almost the price of a pack. So I almost feel, you know, if someone's willing to just open this or get a really good deal opening it, I think you should just, I mean, maybe, you know, once in a while roll the dice. Oh my god, are you kidding me? That is the worst. That is the worst letdown in the set, Odric. You're like, you build up a character. You're like, hey, this character is really cool. You know, let's put him in the story. Oh, wait, he's a vampire now. Well, he's a vampire, but there's really no synergy to him being a vampire. It's just really out of place. It's like a vampire hero, but not a true vampire. Like, I'm not even going to go into it. You, if you disprove me, go read it again and be like, that's the rare that you want to pull. Okay, this is good. I didn't actually get one of these, but this will go in my zombie deck for sure. This is another great zombie here. I need one of these. Fel Stinger. I mean, a zombie scorpion, sure. Why not? Everything's a zombie now. And this is like just cool. Sigardus Summons. Cool. If you're playing a token commander thing. A lot of this is commander fodder. I mean, this is like a dollar here tops. Two slow lands. Remember, it's all the opposite that the stuff that we didn't get from the last set. Sorry. I need to tilt this. I don't want you guys to break your neck watching this worthless video here of pulling crap. This is really cool, and this gives the guy flying. It's really good. Fang Frame. Okay, now Patchwork Crawler, this can stand the test of time. Anything that you exiled with this card, it gains all the activated abilities, and that's all that power is always going to increase. So I've gotten really good blue stuff out of this. Are you kidding me? Modern Horizons 2 now is this list is junk. That is junk. I've pulled five list cards. That's my first time. Modern Horizons is still in print. I know it's not a standard card, but wow. I'm not keeping track of these foils, these basic land foils. I'm not going to play with them. They're too dark for me. I know it's got the blue border. It's got the symbol, blah, 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 but I haven't really seen even much that I would play with here. Okay, so hold on. This is a commander card. Whenever this creature attacks, each opponent mills cards equal to its toughness. Okay, I think I could probably play that in my mill deck, potentially. Mirror Hall Mimic, where you get to copy things. You got foil rare. And then, okay, so the abilities just copy. And then let's see here. A 3-1 flying vampire. Oh, I got one of these. Okay. Man, five list cards and not good. two slow lands, worthless mythics. I mean, and so far I've only gotten two mythics. Remember that, like that last time I pulled three mythics in a box. But then the next one I got five. And I'm not, okay, so they downgraded this. This was an original Theros. That was a rare, now it's an uncommon. I still like Midnight Rider, but again, that's not in standard anymore. So that's, if you don't wanna lose life, gotta play. All right, okay. Cemetery Prowler, really good wolf. Three mana for a 3/4 vigilance. I mean, even if you aren't playing a wolf deck, that's solid for green. And exile card from any graveyard. That can be some graveyard hate or take out your own stuff and start playing creatures cheaper, start playing spells cheaper, you know, whatever you do. Monster of the week. Okay, so I kind of redeemed myself there. I'm okay. I'm okay. I like a Sorin. And I like Chandra, perhaps? A human token. But I will take the, with this set, it's the Cemetery. 5 damage to creature or planeswalker. For 3 mana, an extra 2 damage to its controller if it happened to be a spirit. A lot of wolves, a lot of vamps. All right, Graf Reaver, great zombie card. 3/3 for 2, an exploit. It can exploit itself and destroy target planeswalker. So that's really good, cheap planeswalker hate. Blood Tithe Harvester. And that human token. Okay, last of the second wave. What do you guys think of this set? I still think Midnight Hunt was better. I'm waiting for Kamigawa now, because I feel like Kamigawa, there was so much time that passed between this set, or the one that is coming out, and the original. They haven't been to that world yet. Seems like they're going in the future, which, okay, hold on. Dominating Vampire. Okay, I guess I'll put that with the red. Okay, Old Rutstein or Rutstein, Courier Bat, and oh, sweet. Okay, I have this already, but now I have a very good copy from Legions, Noxious Ghoul. Or do I have this one? Yeah, anytime like a zombie comes into play, everything that's non-zombie gets -1/-1. That's a solid list card, and I've already gotten 6, so if I can get 2 out of this last row, that's above curve. A little down on the mythics, though. Only got 3. If I can get 5, I'm ahead. So, I mean, okay, I got 2 signature cards on this box, and this one is Daria Klebnikova. I'm pulling out some European artists now. Okay, it doesn't feel like I'm getting as many of the commander cards as I did last time. Maybe I just got really lucky because I pulled Elanois and the guy in the box. the zombie god himself. Okay. Not a good card. Zombie token. Okay. Only 2 slow lands. I could use a lot more. I got a lot more on the last go-round. I actually don't think these are the ones worth getting. I think the last set needs it more than these. The colors in this one, they don't need any restrictions. They need to be playing lands that... I got another one of these. Got the Markhall Waltzer. I didn't know that came in the arm. Okay, Voldaren Bloodcaster. Alluring Suitor and a copy token. Getting some vamp rares. Okay. Remember, I probably won't get another list card for the whole thing. So we'll see. We'll see. Fear of Death. Oh man, I'm messing up my piles. Scattered Thoughts. Presence, Cradle of Safety, Guideline Snare, Wizard. It seems like you kind of get the same variances in this. Okay, first time I've gotten this. What does it transform into? A creature that gives you 1 mana of any color at the beginning of your main phase. Here's our rare mythic. What is this? The beginning of your upstep, grand step, create. a token if you control exactly 13 permanents. If you... No. I mean, it's cool if you can... God, lead. 3 common list box. Okay. That might be it, folks, for the list cards. And that is bad. Bad. Very bad. Now I need mythics. Mythics, please. Give me something. Value. See, a lot of this stuff I'm not even gonna play. I mean, okay, we got a Cemetery Protector. This is my second one. I got this in the pre-release kit. Got a foil and a boar token, a piggy. Okay, that's my fourth mythic. I got 2 Cemetery Prowlers. Let's just pull this off here. 1 mythic. 2 mythics. I'm not counting the commander ones, because you get those. Did I get 4? Okay, Jacob. Oh yeah, and then I got a Hallowed Haunting. Okay, not bad. 4 mythics. Need some more slow lands though. What is there? There's red white. Red blue. God, look at this. 3. 3 art signature cards in a box from Marta Nail. That's a first. That is a, like, let's ding, 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 ding. 3 signatures in a box in my set box opening history here on this channel. Cool. Not a fan. I mean, it helps you get these cards if you care about the art. Oh, dig up's not bad. 1 green mana, you can just search for basic land card, put it in your hand. But if you pay this Golgari cost here of 1 double black and a green, it basically turns into a tutor. You can just grab anything. And I got a foil, Thirst for Discovery, and an insect token. Okay, so we're running out of packs here. We're down to 5 packs out of this 30 pack box. 1 mythic will put us ahead of the curve, and 1 more set card or list card from the set booster box. So I guess I've hit my quota, per se, my Wizards Magic Gathering quota. This is all you get. This is all you get, Chris. Okay, cool. I needed this. Not only is it a wolf, but it's basically Elvish Piper, just a little with a little bit bigger body, costs a little bit more. But when it flips over, you get to basically go 6 down and find something and put it back in your hand. I really like this card. So I'm kind of glad I got that, because that has a lot of flavor to me. You know, hey, I can play the biggest, baddest things, and now they only... cost 2. If it happens to be in my wolf deck, I get to untap her and do it all over again. And keep it going. Wish I would have got that in the limited. Boy, oh boy. Okay, Paxong Pup. I could use him. What is this? Go 7 down, put 2 lands, put them in the battlefield, tap. Okay. And that's actually 2 of any land cards, not just basic lands. That might see, if you play a lot of lands, you can get what you want. Oh, hold on. Okay, Dying to Serve. Whenever you discard 1 or more cards, create a 2/2 zombie. You can only do this once a turn. Still, that's solid, because I need zombie cards. And number 8, and a foil white card. We're down to 3 packs. Okay, give me a, I'd rather take a slow land than junk rare. I think everybody else would too. No list in this one. Waiting for Kamigama. It's gonna be really hard pressed for me to open this second box. I have to be really bored to open it, because again, not much value. And when I buy these, I don't know what's in the set. I buy them early to get a, you know, lock in. Hey, there's my first duplicate rare of the set. Happens to be a vamp, so not complaining. And so yeah, I am just waiting for the next set, and I don't think it comes out until, well, I'm skipping the the double feature, which is basically both these sets combined at your LGS only, and one card is a black and white foil card of this same art to homage to old horror flicks of the 70s. If you're into that, cool, go to your local LGS. If you, to me, I don't want to pay a premium for the same product that's, you know, it's literally a reprint. So I'm not going to mess with it. Not a lot of gold, but when I do, I guess I get both those. Okay, cool. This is a Parasitic Grass. So for two mana, it's, you know, deals three damage to a human, and then you gain three life. For three mana, you can do it to any creature. Desperate Farmer. All right. Sweet. Stormcarved Coast. I pulled one of those at the sealed. So I have two of those. And I think that's it. I don't think I got any of the spirit. Okay, so the slug token is very rare. If you can get the slug token, you probably have a dollar on your hands. Okay, last pack. You know, screw this. I should just... Okay, you know what? We're not going to open the last pack. We're going to open up this box topper first. I'm not counting this towards the... oh my gosh, look at this. Look how much glue. I'm like literally bending the card. Ugh, wizards. Okay, let's just remove all glue to... Oh boy. I'm not counting this as a mythic because this is an extra product or promo thing. Now, again, I don't know if they devalued the set because, you know, you're getting this box topper. But remember, half these box toppers are going to be uncommon. This box is not good, so this will probably be an uncommon, and I was completely right. Look at this. Quincy Harker. I don't know who the... I don't follow the Dracula lore or anything. That's essentially worthless. Maybe five now. It'll be a dollar a month from now. Cool, right? Thanks, Wizards. I didn't get any Thalias. That's what I really wanted. If I can find a Thalia for like $5, I'm going to have to buy one now. I thought I could get Thalia. She's back in the set, so no Thalia, but... Oh, okay, look at this. Cemetery Illuminator. Pulled one of these at the pre-release. Wow, my third Torrens. I got every little variant. Torrens. Okay. That concludes the set booster box. I'm going to have to run it down and see which uncommons I didn't get. But man, this is... okay, so I guess... Well, first of all, I should be positive on this. Okay, so we got five mythics, three of the cemetery cycle. So that is the plus on this. We got the three signed art cards, which is really cool because, again, getting two is rare. I think I've only done that once or twice. And did I get another one, or did they start putting this another? I thought I got a third. Yeah, here we go, and a third. So we got the three art cards. We got three slow lands, five mythics, and did I get... And then we got, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 list cards. Nothing really worth anything. Especially with that Times Frost since they just reprinted. But anyways, that's the box. 6 out of 10. Maybe 7 if the cemetery cycle goes up. But yeah. Anyways, hope you enjoy. The box topper really killed this box. But I don't even know what you can really get that's good. I know there's a Soren, but you know, it just depends if you like the art, I guess. I guess it's foil. So yeah. All right, guys, enjoy. I'm sure you'll do better than what I did. Later.